What's up, Ant City, and welcome back to the third and potentially final Dokkan Battle concept. So, before we get this video started, as you may have noticed, I just said potentially final Dokkan Battle concept, and that is because if you guys want me to, if you guys, you know, leave comments, like the video, whatever, but just let me know if you guys want me to do one more Dokkan concept, because I actually have an idea. Which actually that could potentially lead to two more, and I won't spoil what they are, but I will say they're both original Dragon Ball, like OG, like not Dragon Ball Z, before Dragon Ball Z, the OG Dragon Ball. They would both be concepts surrounding that like part of the Dragon Ball series. So let me know if you all want to see that, because I have two ideas, which I mean, I'm sure like 90% of you can guess what those two ideas are. But you know, if y'all really want though, I will make those two celebration concepts, but again, that's all completely up to y'all. So anyways, you've seen the title, you've seen the thumbnail of this video. We're just gonna go ahead and hop straight in. You can even see on the screen right now Broly and Future Trunks Saga. Y'all know what's going on here today, so let's just jump straight in. So first, for the main LR, so the very first main LR is gonna be a Blue Goku and Vegeta. So these aren't gonna be like the fifth year anniversary LRs where they start off as Gogeta and Vegito. It's gonna be a Blue Goku and Vegeta that fuses into Gogeta and Vegito respectively. So yeah, the first one is the Gogeta side. Obviously I had to use the DBS Broly movie poster just because like that's just such perfect art, like just them in that pose right there, like that's perfect LR, and like I'm showing right here, literally that's the only picture I used, because to me it's just literally the perfect pose, like just the perfect LR art right there. You will notice though that I have these guys as Blue Goku and Vegeta as opposed to like base form Goku and Vegeta. And honestly, the only reason for that is because I thought the super attacks would be a lot cooler if they were in blue. But the only time they've ever done like a transformed version before they fuse is the old third year anniversary LRs where they were Super Saiyan Goku and Vegeta. And then they fuse into Gogeta Vegito. But now it feels like they're trying to do it in a more canon sense. So they might actually have these guys start off in base, but at the same time, maybe not. Because they didn't really fight in base form in either in the Goku Black arc or the Broly movie. They literally just are only in base for the fusion. So as long as they're in base for the active skill or the, you know, the fusion transformation, then that should be fine. Because they even did that for the Super Saiyan Goku and Vegeta. When they fuse into Gogeta Vegito for the actual transformation or the fusion, they are in base form. So I think that having them start off as blue would work. Like, I think it actually is plausible because they never actually fought in base before they fused. Wire in both the Tech Gogeta and the SCR Vegito, those Goku and Vegetas actually did fight in base while these didn't. So I think having them start off in blue makes the most sense. So anyways, getting into the next one is the Blue Goku and Vegeta, same name. That is one thing that we'll talk about in a second. But yeah, these are just two different scenes I thought were cool. Yeah, just, you know, Blue Goku and Vegeta just standing there. These are both from the Goku Black arc. As you can see, Goku's got, like, the battle damage and everything. So, yeah, these are both shots from the Goku Black arc. The one thing with these units, though, is you notice they both would have the same name. So they actually wouldn't be able to link together. Because, you know, the Tech Gogeta, SCR Vegito, those units are basically designed to be ran together. These units wouldn't be. That's the one, like, thing about them, you wouldn't really be able to run these guys together, because even the old like physical and Int Goku or Gogeta and Vegito, I think you could run those together because they had slightly different names, but there's not really because you know they had one that was like Angel or one that wasn't Angel, they were both Angel. I think one of them had both of them Angel and one of them only had one of the units Angel, or they were both like I think the Vegito they were both alive, and then the Gogeta, the physical one, they were both Angel. That's what it is. But these guys, you know, they never fused as Angel, quote-unquote, for the Broly movie or the Goku Black arc, so I don't see how they would make them link up, really. Maybe they could just have the Goku and Vegeta from Broly start off in, like, God instead of Blue. I don't know. But that's one thing with these units. This would be, like, the first Gogeta Vegeta that don't link until maybe after the fusion, of course. But I guess the way they could appease that is just make the fusion requirements, you know, easy. Like, easy to get and not too, like, difficult and, like, you have to be below all this hell. Like, make it easy so that way you can have the Gogeta Vegeta link up easy. So anyways, the next part of this is the super attacks. So First, we're getting into the Broly movie, Goku and Vegeta. So the first thing I did for their 12-key super attack, so basically it's going to start off with Goku and Vegeta posed up. That's why this is slowed down. And then it's going to have, you know, Goku doing these all these like punches and stuff on him. And then Vegeta's going to jump in and do some attacks too. I pulled from the Super Saiyan portion of the fight. And then Goku finish off with that Rasengan thing. And then it could zoom in on both Goku and Vegeta. So that's kind of the theme I went with for both of these, the Gogeta and the Vegito, for the Goku and Vegeta part. It's going to be Goku and Vegeta attacking together. So they can just string stuff together like I did here. And yeah, so it's going to start off with them like posed up, and then, you know, they'll both like rush at Broly. And then, you know, Goku just goes in for the attacks. And then Vegeta hops in and helps out as well. I just, you know, something like that. It doesn't have to be exactly what I did. I just strung stuff together. And then the 18 key would be the Gallic Kamehameha. So it would start off behind them. And then literally this scene right here, straight up the movie. What the main reason, though, if you've, you probably understand this already, but the main reason I pulled that exact like super attack right there is because this is actually what they used in Legends for the LF Blue Goku and Vegeta from the Broly movie. This scene with the Gallic Kamehameha. So they could basically just copy exactly what Legends did, maybe add a few things like the beginning camera angle and stuff. They could just do that, but I basically just use the exact same scene that they use for Legends. And that's also kind of what this one was based on too, but not completely. Like the 12 key, it's kind of the same, but not really. The 18 key is basically the exact same scene though. Like they could literally just copy what Legends did and it would work exactly as I'm intending it to. So to match that though, we have the, oh, let's go, the Vegito Goku Vegeta super attack. So again, the 12 key is just Goku and Vegeta like posed up, and then they rush in to do like these this combo attack. I think this would be kind of sick if they strung this together. So I will explain right here at the end though. So if you noticed what, because that might have been a little confusing. So basically right here, you know, they're beating up Zamasu. Well, because, you know, in the actual anime, they fought Zamasu and Goku Black separately, but obviously in Dokkan, it would just be the one enemy. So we have Goku like kick him into a wall, right? And so after Goku does that, Vegeta would come in and grab the enemy and then slam them into the ground. And then once they bounce back up, Goku would teleport in and slam them back down into the ground. And then it would do this huge like blue explosion thing. I just think that would be really cool. And again, the main theme of this was just having Goku and Vegeta do some combo attacks together. And then the 18 key. Now, if you'll notice when I play the clip, this actually isn't technically from the Goku Black arc, but there's a reason that I pulled this. So Goku and Vegeta here would also be doing this from the Tournament of Power, but it is also a Gallic Kamehameha. That was the reason I pulled this, just because I think it'd be cool if both units are doing like the same super attacks here, you know. That scene right there, actually, this little clip, let me see if I can pause it at the right time. Right here, this is actually from the Goku Black arc. Just because it's kind of, you know, Goku and Vegeta together doing it. But if you actually look, if I go slow enough, this isn't actually a Gallic Kamehameha. Because, like, look, Vegeta is charging up a blue blast, and so is Goku. So it's not actually a Gallic Kamehameha. But they could just use it. Like, I just pulled that scene in there just because it is from the Goku Black arc. Just, you know, so it's not completely pulled from the Tournament of Power. But the basic idea here is that they actually do a Gallic Kamehameha in the Tournament of Power. So I think it'd be cool if they're doing, like, you know, because we actually got one from the Broly movie, so I think it'd be cool if the Vegito unit is also doing a Gallic Kamehameha, just because it'll have them match, and I think it's cool. Plus, I don't know if they're ever, I could see them maybe not using this, though, because I could see them saving this Gallic Kamehameha for, like, a unit super attack in the future or something. I could see them potentially doing that, so they might not pull that here, but I just did it for my concept, because I thought it'd be sick if the units are matching. So then next, we have the Gogeta and Vegito transformations. I call them transformations, but it's really just a fusion. So you're probably wondering how this is going to work, especially with, you know, the LR, the 5-year anniversary fusions. And I'll explain. You'll see it when I play the video. So first, let's look at Gogeta. So basically, straight out the movie, they would pull that fusion dance exactly from the movie with, you know, the swirling around, like the blue and orange swirls and everything like that. But, so it's gonna, you know, do this, do the swirl, it'll burst out. And then it'll, you know, have the cracking or whatever you want to call it. And then it'll zoom in on, like, all the parts of Gogeta. But then I pull from Fighters right here, because this is where the quote would be. And then these units are going to go directly into blue. So they're not going to be like fusion, then base form, then blue. It's just going to be, you know, they're going to fuse and then go directly into blue, which is why I think pulling from fighters would be the move that they take for this, especially because that also gives them the chance to have the quote. Because you see in fighters, Gogeta like talks a little bit because, you know, in fighters, they have the intros. So Gogeta talks a little bit before actually going into blue. So to me, that would be the best way to do this kind of unit, is just pulling the transformation from fighters. Same thing with Vegito. He's going to end up using the fighter's transformation too, just because they literally start in base and then go directly to blue. And it makes the most sense, in my opinion, because they're not going to fuse together and then immediately start in blue. They would start in base as soon as they fuse and then transform. So I think that would be the way that they do it. So let's look at the Vegito here. The Vegito actually string together a lot of things. So it starts off with the anime, right? But then it goes into the Kakarot scene. Now, the reason I did this is because Kakarot also used that orange and blue tornado effect that Gogeta has. So I think it would be cool to like use that to match the two units. Same reason I did the Gallic Kamehameha on the Vegito, just to match what Gogeta was doing, just because I think it'd be cool to have the units kind of parallel each other like that. Because they even did that for the 5-year anniversary fusions. Gogeta and Vegito do reference each other a lot in their animations. So I think having them do a similar thing here would be cool. So yeah, so same thing with the Gogeta, like I said though. And also, you notice I did a little transition from Kakarot here straight into fighters. So yeah, but basically same thing. They would just go into the fusion and then transform directly into blue, and they can use fighters for that. Vegito is interesting though. It's different than the Gogeta, because Vegito actually talks after going blue, while Gogeta talks before going blue. But I mean, they could either leave that or just change it to where Vegito's talking before blue, you know, whatever they want to do. But either way, I think the best way to do this unit for my concept here is have them go directly into blue, because then they won't clash with the 5-year anniversary LRs. You can actually run them together on teams, because they won't have the same name ever, except for when the 5th-year anniversary LRs transform and they'll both be blue. But I think they would still be able to link together in that scenario. So yeah, anyways though, moving on to the next segment of this is the art for blue Gogeta. So we got 3 different arts that they could use here, you know, just some basic stuff, you know, Gogeta doing that pose there in the top left, and then him with like the blue energy blast that he does to Broly, and then him just like with the close-up like face. Obviously it would show his full body in Dokkan, because that's how Dokkan arts are, but I think having him like do that smile there would be cool. There's a reason for that though, which I'll actually show you right now, is because it would match what I picked for Vegito. So if you look at the bottom art, the Gogeta one matches the Vegito one. Like, they're both smiling. That's the only reason I picked that bottom one. I don't think they're going to use that. They could. It's obviously a possibility, but I picked that just because, you know, they're both smiling. And then for Vegito, that top left one, I think would be some sick LR art. Just because of, like, you see the orange, like, energy blast, like, the fire coming off. I could see them doing a really cool effect with that. And then the top right one is just, you know, a Vegito pose, and he does that in the Goku Black arc. So, yeah. So then now we're going to get into the super attack. So I've seen a lot. So something I want to talk about really quick is I've seen a lot of people talking about how they don't think the anniversary is going to be Gogeta and Vegito, because they don't know. Like, they were saying they basically ran out of animations to use for them, but I actually completely disagree. And, you know, here's my concept. Like, this whole video will show you what I'm talking about. So first of all, for the 12 key, so the 5th-year anniversary Blue Gogeta did use some of the CGI scenes from the Broly movie, but it actually didn't use all of them, and I think there's enough there that they didn't use for them to make a whole new super attack. So let's play it right now. So Gogeta punches him, the enemy, then does those, like, machine gun punches, and he kicks you away, and then punches you, and then it cracks, like, the dimension, like, at the end of the CGI section. So I think that alone is enough for a 12 key super attack. Like, it looks really good. I especially think these machine gun punches right here are sick, but I think it works for a 12 key super attack. You know, I think that they can string that together perfectly, and just a little cracking at the end of the animation is really cool. So, like cracking of the dimension or whatever. So yeah, but next we have Blue Gogeta's 18 key. So one thing with that is another thing that they also have done a lot before in Dokkan is pull from heroes. So this 18 key super attack is literally all just straight out of heroes. And now, to be fair, I don't know if they're allowed to just pull a whole super attack straight out of heroes. But they can at least use some of what I'm showing here for a super attack. So Gogeta does his Kamehameha, but that's actually not the end of the super attack. He would fly through it and then do this punch that he did on Hearts, which, you know, has the little like blue energy come out of his back, and then the enemy would just disintegrate. And then the KO screen would be Gogeta just looking down like that. So again, I don't know if they're allowed to pull just a whole animation from Heroes, but I mean, looking at Tech Gogeta, the 12 key for him, they basically took stuff from Heroes and then also promo art, and they just kind of string that together for Super Attack. So I think they could come up with something. And like I said, for the 12 key, they have plenty of stuff they could use because we have the whole CGI section. They haven't used everything from that yet. So I think that they definitely have stuff they can use. And I think the same is also true for Vegito here. So the first thing with Vegito is I pulled from the base Vegito portion of the fight with Buhan. Just because, you know, they didn't really use many animations from that. So, well, they used some, I will admit. But I just pulled from the base Vegito portion. So, you know, he does all these punches and kicks. And then he has, like, this air blast move that he does. Obviously, it wouldn't just, like, cut Boo like it does during the actual anime. So this, like, blast move here could actually be, like, a strong gust of wind that pushes the enemy away after all these punches and kicks. So, yeah, I think that they definitely have stuff here that they could use. But you got to keep in mind, I didn't even pull from the super... Okay, this video is really laggy, jeez. But I didn't even pull from the Super Vegito portion of this fight. So there's plenty of stuff they could pull from. Like, plenty of stuff there that they could pull from, too. So just keep that in mind, that there's, like, plenty of Super Vegito stuff they could use. So they definitely got an animation for Vegito. But same thing I did with Gogeta. They could also pull from Heroes for Vegito Blue. Specifically the fight when he goes up against Cumber. So, you know, he does like this little punch and then he's comboing Cumber, then he kicks him away, and then he goes into a final Kamehameha. Just, you know, again, they can pull it from Heroes if they want to, or if they're allowed to. I know they're allowed to, yeah, at least use some stuff from Heroes. I just don't know if they're allowed to use everything and the super attack here cut off, just because in the actual episode the final Kamehameha doesn't like hit, it gets canceled out. So yeah, that's basically what I have for their 12 and 18 keys, though. Just, you know, in my opinion, I think they have plenty of stuff they can use for both, you know, Blue Goku and Vegeta, like, before they fused and then after they fused. I think there's plenty of stuff they could use, but they could even... There's probably stuff I didn't even think of that they could also pull from. So, you know, but I just think that they have potential to make another LR. Like, I think there's plenty of stuff that they could use for that. So next, we're going to get into the nullification encounter. So these units, much like the very first video I did with the Resurrection F, I think this Gogeta and Vegito should have a nullification slash counter. I put slash because this could be a nullification and a counter, or just a nullification. So first, let's get into Gogeta. So his would actually be the Punisher Shield move that he does. And I pulled from Xenoverse here because for the counterpart, he could do the kick down. Because in Xenoverse, so the Punisher Shield is actually this right here. If you look really... This is actually kind of hard to see in the actual movie, but he pulls up, like, this blue shield, and then it launches Broly's Ki Blast back at him. You notice the little explosion there? So it does this, and then it blows up right in Broly's face. But in Xenoverse, if you hit that move, Gogeta will follow it up with this other attack where he does this kick. So I think that would be a good way to do Vegeta or Gogeta's nullification. So it could be, like, a Ki Blast nullification and then a counter. And then Vegito's would also be a Ki Blast nullification. So I used this scene right here because I just think this is a sick scene when he catches Zamasu's like holy wrath and then just blows it up, and then he just has his fist out, and then they could just follow it up with, you know, the punch that he does on Zamasu when he catches him off guard, because that does happen like right after this scene. Like, they talk for a little bit and Zamasu's like monologuing, and then Vegito just goes up and punches him. So I think that they could definitely use that as like a nullification, just because it would be a sick animation that they haven't used. If you couldn't tell, I'm trying to cover like all the bases of what they haven't used from both of these movies yet. One thing I will say, though, is before we move on to the next segment, there are two things that I'm going to link down in the description, because there's actually some other ideas that people had. So I've seen a concept on Twitter of a Gogeta super attack for an LR Gogeta too. There's a super attack there that I didn't include in this video, but I think is still definitely a possibility. So I'll link that in the description, as well as there's this thing, or like, I guess you could say like mod. I don't really know what to call it, but it's called Dokkan Phoenix. And right now, actually, as I was making this PowerPoint, like I was checking Twitter and I found out they actually happen to be working on a Blue Goku and Vegeta that fuse into Vegito. But I think it's from Heroes. It's like it's not from the actual anime, like Goku Black Arc Vegito. It's like a Heroes one. But I will link that in the description because, again, that's just even more super attacks that they could pull, that they could use that I didn't include, especially mostly for the Vegito. I think that their Blue Goku and Vegeta actually is like a Resurrection F based one. And then it goes into like the, I think it's called Capsule Corp Vegito. I'll just link it in the description and the comments, both of them, so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. But again, like I said, I think they have plenty of stuff they can pull from for a Blue Vegito and a Blue Gogeta. So for those of y'all saying like they ran out of animations, I disagree. But like I said, so that's just like, you know, if you want to see some extra content, like extra ideas, I'll link them down below. But next, let's get on to the next section, which is side units. So again, just like every other video, we have some units that they could put as the side units for the banner. So I think the first one, in my opinion, that would be cool is a base form Broly, because we actually don't have like a TUR base Broly in the game. The only base Brolys we have, I think we only have one, which is the, you know, the AGL Broly that you can pull. He starts as base. And then there's this int free-to-play Broly, but he transforms into Super Saiyan, and then the AGL one goes into Rage Broly. So I think having a base form Broly would be cool. This is also kind of, if you look on the R on the right, I'm also basing this pick off of Legends, because Legends are, like, if you notice the Legends celebration right now that's going on with the Blue Goku and Vegeta and stuff, it seems like they're also trying to cover all their bases for the Broly movie. Like, it feels like they're putting in the last few units of things that they didn't do from Broly. So now they have every like scene of the Broly movie in the game. Like, that's what it feels like they're doing. So I think having a base Broly would be a cool side banner unit. And you'll see my next pick, the reason that it's specifically base Broly, because we could get like another Rage Broly, but we already have one and he's pretty good. So I think having like a base Broly, being able to like link up with him and everything would be cool. So yeah, and then the art. This picture on the left actually is, again, the DBS Broly movie poster. But if you notice, you can see more of it, and it's kind of a different orientation and everything. Like, it looks a little different. It's because this is actually the Dokkan loading screen. I picked this one, though, just because you could see more of Broly's body. And I think him, like, having his back to the camera and, like, looking back would be cool SSR art. And then for the TUR art, I just picked what they used in Legends. Even though that looks more like Rage Broly, now I'm, like, after I looked at it, I was realizing that looks like Rage. But you can tell by the eyes it is, in fact, base form Broly. So yeah, but I think those would be cool arts. And another reason that my pick, like, you know, being base Broly and then that R on the left is sick, is because my pick for the Vegito banner is a base Goku Black. So if you look on the left, it's kind of like the same pose Broly has. So he's got like his back to the camera and he's looking, but Goku Black, obviously being Goku Black, is just a lot more sinister looking. I don't think he's gonna have the sword stab through him in Dokkan, you know, but yeah, that again, that's just like such a sick looking scene. I think having it be a base Goku Black is cool, because again, we only have two base Goku Blacks in the game. One is that physical one, but he's a pretty old unit. And then we do have the int one, but he's a transforming unit. So I think having just a standalone base Goku Black would be cool, especially because of the super attack I picked for him, which we'll look at in a second. I think that would be the best way to like do it. Like, I think that would be the best super attack for a Goku Black. Plus, I think that these two being side banner units makes sense, because I couldn't think of anyone else to put as a side unit, if I'm being honest. I might not have just been thinking right. You guys can like put your ideas down in the comments if you want, but I couldn't think of anyone else. And I thought base Broly, like I said, Legends is what inspired me for that pick. And then I was like, base Broly, so let's do a base Goku Black, that kind of goes together. So yeah, so next let's look at their super attacks. So first we have Broly here, and let's just go ahead and play it so I can kind of talk through it. So it would start off at the very beginning of when Goku fights Broly, or yeah, when Goku's fighting Broly. So he would like launch off this ice, punch Goku, and then I love this segment of the movie when we go like first person seeing Broly shoot out the blast. And then I think that big blast that gets shown at the end right here, this like really big like blast that he's just like pushes into Goku's chest, I think that's a really cool super attack. So the main reason I did it though was just because I love this first person section, and I want to see it like this when Dokkan would look so sick. And then, you know, the big blast is just a cool way to end it off because we were doing a bunch of key blasts. I think another thing they could do for this, though, is the scene where Broly is just, like, when he grabs Goku by the leg and starts slamming him around. The only thing with that is I feel like that'd be more fitting for a Rage Broly, you know, like a... But just, like, a Rage Broly, I think that's more fitting for that. But I think that this works for a base form Broly, you know? Because, like, you know, the Rage Broly, he's, like, this big hulking monster, so him, like, slamming Goku around fits. Even though, technically, this Broly in this super attack that I'm using is Rage Broly, I think them putting it onto base form Broly wouldn't be too weird, you know? So, next, let's get into the Goku Black super attack. So, this one, I picked it because we don't actually really have a good animated version of this in the game, and that is the normal black Kamehameha, so like that purple Kamehameha that he does. And I actually pulled from two different scenes here just because there are two different scenes in the anime where he uses it, so I feel like they could put them together. So the first one, like this one right here where the super attack ends, so like it zooms in on Goku Black's face and he starts charging it. So this part is actually from the episode where Trunks is like explaining where Goku Black came from, and then this one right here comes from when Trunks is like escaping to the past and Goku Black catches him. So I just kind of string those together just because it would be different and more original. And I also think this would be a cool like screen where all the damage and stuff shows up. I think this would be really cool to base it off of. So yeah, that's basically my pick for Goku Black, though, because we don't actually have a good animated like normal Black Kamehameha. We have like a very old one, like the physical Goku Black. If you didn't have him SA10 back in the day, he would just do the normal Black Kamehameha. But since then, we like even that was like such an old unit and we don't have like a good nicely animated one, so that's why I went ahead and picked this. And I couldn't think of another side banner unit, so but I think this actually does work pretty well for a side banner unit. So then next we get into the free to play units. So again, like I've done in every video, there's side units and free to play. So I didn't have too many ideas for free to play units, but I did think of something that could be cool. So I think one free to play unit could be Chi-Lai. And this would just be like her TUR and then, or her SSR and then TUR art. I think another way they could do this though is as a Chi-Lai and Lemo together as a unit. I just picked Chi-Lai by herself, and you'll, again, if you've noticed, the theme of this celebration is kind of just matching the Gogeta and Vegito sides. So my pick for the Vegito side, which we'll show you right here in a second, it matches Chi-Lai. So my pick, it was Mai for that arc. And for the Vegito side, and I think it works because, you know, both of them are using guns here and everything, and, you know, they were both like the main females for their respective things. So like in DBS Broly, Chi-Lai was like the main female, and then Future Trunks, Mai was the main female. So I think it kind of works out that way. So now let's get into the super attack. So Chi-Lai, if you notice, I actually have her in her spaceship here, and this is why I said it could be a Chi-Lai and Lemo when I play it, you'll see. But the reason I did her spaceship is because we actually already have an LR Broly, Chi-Lai, and Lemo together. And in that super attack, she's already like using her gun. So I felt like doing something more original would be cool. So I think what they should do is have them like during this scene where they're like flying around and stuff, just have them fly around like this, like all crazy. And then they just like crash into either the enemy, which is why the super attack ends right there with that burst. So that could be them crashing into the enemy, or they could just like crash to the planet and then it blows up. And that's what does the damage. I just think that was like, to me, it was just like something different than just her shooting her gun, which I mean, obviously they could just do that, but I just used a little spaceship because it was different. And then for Mai, I picked the scene where she snipes Goku Black just because this was a really cool scene. And it's something we don't actually have animated into Dokkan yet. So it is pretty quick. It's pretty short. But I think this was a pretty cool scene in the Goku Black arc. Because I remember when I first saw that, I was like, did she actually kill Goku Black with a sniper? I was like, there's no way. She didn't, spoiler alert. But so I think that this would just be a cool super attack with Mai doing the little sniper. Because we have something similar to this animated in Dokkan, but it's not this exact scene. So I think it could still make it work. Especially the part right here where Goku Black does get sniped. Like, this would be part of the super attack, like it turning all red and everything. I just think that would be really cool, and it's something they could definitely do. Like, I think it's definitely a possibility. So then next, we get into the last free-to-play unit here. So I think that this Rage Trunks, because again, this is another unit I've had in my box for a long time, but he only stops right here. Like right here, I don't have him rainbowed, but this is basically his full maxed out state. You can't Dokkan Awaken him past this. So I think them giving him another Dokkan Awakening would be very fitting for this celebration, and I think that he just deserves it, you know. So yeah, and yeah, you know, I've just, this unit's just been out for a while, so I think finally Dokkan Awakening him now would be cool. So then next we're gonna move into these two units. So these are two other units I think they could Dokkan Awaken. So these are both actually units you get from Dokkan events, much like, the reason I have them on here as possible for Dokkan Awakening is because of that Int Frieza. So there's like this Int SR like pod Frieza, you know, that was also from a Dokkan event. But during the, I forgot when they did it, but it was like a while back, they gave him a Dokkan Awakening and an EZA. All the, like, he went from like this pod Frieza all the way into like a final form EZA'd Frieza. And he became a very good unit. So I think it's within the realm of possibility for these two to get that same treatment, for them to go from, like, you know, base, like, you know, unawakened, like this Zamasu on the left, that's literally the highest you can get him SSR. He doesn't even have a normal, like, awakening. So I think getting them all the way up to, like, TUR with, I almost said Zenkais, with EZAs would be possible at the very least. Like, I don't know if they will do it, but I think it's a possibility, so... Yeah, I just put them on here as like a discussion point, but again, I don't know how likely it is. And you notice there's no units on here from the Broly movie, because there's really none that they have in the game that don't have like Dokkan Awakenings already. So yeah, but that does move us into our next section, which is story events. So the first story, honestly, the only story event I have on here is this one, the Future Trunks Saga, because you know that Rage Trunks I just talked about that I said could get a Dokkan Awakening? He comes from this event, but you have to get him as an SR. So I think that that would be reason enough for them to like revamp this story event. So that way he, you know, you can get him as like an SSR at least, and then get him Dokkan Awakened and everything. Like they usually do, you get SSRs, grind those out, and then you can rainbow the unit. Plus this event's just kind of old. So I think that they could definitely revamp it. Now you notice I don't have any of the DBS Broly story events on here, because there's actually two in the game. But I honestly don't think those really need full revamps. I think if they're going to do the free-to-play Chilai that I had, I think if they're going to do that, they could just add new stages. I don't think they need to completely revamp the event. But I think this event right here, the Future Trunks one, is old enough to warrant a revamp of the event, just because of how old and that event is, and you have to get that Trunks as an SR. So, yeah. So then, moving into the next section, we have EZA. So... I'm going to warn y'all now, this is going to be a long section, just because there's a lot of units I think they could EZA, but I did order them from, so basically each slide is going to be like the most likely to least likely. So slide one, those two units, it's two units per slide. So slide one, those two I think are the most likely, and then all the way at the bottom, it's like those could still happen, but I don't know as much about those, right? So the first two units I think need and are definitely going to get EZAs during an event like this would be this Int Broly and Physical Frieza from the DBS Broly story event, purely because these are the only two units from that event that don't have EZAs. So you could get five units from that event. There was a base, or not a base, it goes into Blue Goku and Vegeta with the jackets on. Those two units got EZAs. There was this Broly and Frieza here, obviously. They don't have EZAs. And then there was a Gogeta that actually got added after these two, a base Gogeta, who also got an EZA. But these two units don't, so I think it's kind of inevitable for them to get one, especially this Int Broly, because that Int Broly is trash, let me tell you. Like, oh my god, he's like unusable. So him getting an EZA would be great for this celebration. You know, gives us another Broly that we can use. And then the Frieza, he's mostly just a support unit, but they could make him better. And to me, it'd just be weird if they're gonna EZA the units from the story event. Like, might as well do all the ones from the story event, you know? So go ahead and EZA the Frieza too, just because he's also in the story event, and it's just like these two are literally the only ones that were left out from getting EZAs. So I think these two are definitely like, in my opinion, these are like the most likely EZAs to happen, just because, again, they EZA'd every other unit on that story event except for these two. So yeah, so then the next two EZAs that I think are possible are this Int Mai and this Rage Trunk. So I think they're possible just because, again, these are pretty old units. And if they're going for, like, you know, the Future Trunks Saga here, I think it could happen. Especially that Rage Trunks, because I think literally pretty much every other Rage Trunks in the game, besides that free-to-play one I just talked about, so every other TUR Rage Trunks in the game has an EZA already, except this guy. So I think that they could definitely give him one just because, I mean, why not? And I mean, he has some sick art, I'm not going to lie. So I think him being like getting an easy A and actually being usable would make sense. And then the Mai, she's also kind of an old unit. She is a support unit, I think, and she's not terrible. But again, I think she could definitely get an easy A just because of how old she is. And the only other Mai we have in the game is the Peppy Gal's Mai, and she got an easy A. So I think this Mai definitely could get an easy A during this event. So now the next one, for me, I'm kind of iffy on these two. That's why they're in the very middle. So we have this Int Zamasu and the Int Goku Black. So there's a reason I did put these on here. I was kind of reluctant to because I wasn't sure about them, and there's a reason for that. So the reason the Int Zamasu I'm kind of iffy about is because, let's say this celebration, like this Gogeta Vegito celebration, a lot of people are predicting this is going to be the 7th year anniversary. So let's say this does end up being the 7th year anniversary celebration. I don't think this Int Zamasu would get an easy A just because, like, on JP, literally less than a month ago, or maybe exactly a month ago, I don't know, but I think it was when AGL Transforming Trunks came out, they easy A'd the STR Zamasu. And they usually don't like to easy A units of like the, like basically, like let's look at STR Gogeta and Gogeta for example. They didn't easy A those units like back to back because they easy A'd STR Gogeta first because he was older. So they let people have fun with him. And then they eventually easy A'd the Int Gogeta. So because we just got the Zamasu, the STR one easy A'd, I don't see them like just overriding him with this Int one right after, like 2 months later, because the anniversary for JP is going to be in January. And it's currently December right now. So we actually should like pretty soon possibly know what the celebration is going to be. But we'll see. But yeah, but if this 7th year anniversary does end up being the celebration, I don't see this Zamasu getting an easy A. And then the Goku Black, he could get one. I think that he's more possible than the Zamasu, honestly. Because looking at the 6th year anniversary with UI Goku and Evolution Vegeta, they easy A'd the Int UI Goku and he was like a god. Like, you know, he was a really pretty good as a TUR, but his easy A is amazing. So I think this Goku Black, this Int one, could be the UI Goku of the 7th year anniversary celebration. But at, like, the reason I'm still iffy on him is because I feel like it's debatable, but I think that he's still pretty good. You know, he's not like a terrible unit. Like, he's not in desperate need of an easy A like the first four that I showed. Like, they need it. So this Goku Black could get one just if they want to, you know, put a god up for, like, literally, he's a god. But if they want to have a god, like, unit on this celebration, they could do the Goku Black. But I think he's less likely than the first four I showed. But again, it still could happen. Now, these next four easy A's, because like I said, there's a lot of easy A's they could do for the celebration. But these next four, if these next four get easy A'd, oh my god, like, these next four units would be literal Dokkan gods if they got easy A's. So the first two being STR Goku Black and Tech Vegito Blue, especially the Tech Vegito Blue, because his whole thing when he came out was he was a stacking unit, so every time he does a super attack, he raises his attack and defense. So he's kind of outdated now, and he kind of stacks pretty slow. But imagine they easy A him, and he's like up to modern stats, and his stacking is like moderns. That unit would be insane, because I don't think they're gonna get rid of his stacking for an easy A, obviously. But still, like, he would be a crazy, like, broken unit. And, like, oh my god, he would be perfect to use with the LR Vegito Blue that I just showed. Like, oh, he'd be stupid. That's all I have to say. I mean, he doesn't have counters, this is one thing, so that's why physical Vegito Blue could still be better. But I mean, that unit, like, I remember when this unit came out, the Tech Vegito Blue, he was already broken. So him with an easy A, oh my god, he would just be a god. Like, you know, he'd just be a god. And then same thing with STR Goku, like, he doesn't actually do the stacking like Tech Vegito Blue does, which is why he's still the better unit. But I think the Rose, like, I've used this Rose a couple of times, he's still a pretty solid unit, but I think him getting an easy A would just make him that much better, you know. But I honestly, to me, it's that Tech Vegito Blue would be insane with an easy A. But I think this Goku Black, they would, like, if Vegito Blue is gonna be broken, I don't see them, like, just, you know, screwing over this Goku Black. I think that he's gonna get a super good easy A too if he gets one. So yeah, but like I said, these two units and the next two would just be gods. So let's get into the next two units. So these next two I've actually seen come up in discussion a lot too, but it is AGL Gogeta Blue and Broly. So again, I don't. That's why these last four on the bottom of the list, especially these two, because I don't. Because I think these units are still good enough to really not need the EZA. I think if anyone needs it, it's Broly. But this Gogeta, like, okay, when this Gogeta goes blue, he gets guaranteed crit and high chance to dodge already. So, like, the only thing they could add to him for his EZA is, like, I don't know, guaranteed dodge, or, like, throw in some additionals into his passive, maybe. Like, I don't know, something like that. It would have to be something crazy. And then their leader skill, I guess they could just bring, because you notice it's only attack plus 170, and I think HP and defense is 150, so I guess they could just do 170 across the board for that. And then the Broly with him, when he transforms into legendary, I believe he's the one who gets the guaranteed additionals. So I guess they could just give him crit in his passive, or just more additionals. I don't know. But like I said, I think, especially this Gogeta, he, again, just like the Tech Vegito Blue, he would be ridiculous if he got an EZA, depending on what it is. That's why I think it might be a little too soon. Because they would either have to make his EZA mid, like, and you know, not that good, or he would just be broken. So, like, yeah, that's why I'm not sure about this one. But I can see the Broly, because the Broly, all he really gets is additional. He does do crazy damage, though, I will say. But if he got, like, additionals, or maybe he just got, like, a crazy attack buff, like attack plus 256 or something, you know, something like that, I think the Broly could use. But the Gogeta, again, he already gets guaranteed crit and dodge, or not guaranteed dodge, he gets high chance to dodge, but guaranteed crit. But like, I don't think he needs the easy, but I have seen people talk about it, so I thought I would just go ahead and mention it here, because again, I'm not going to completely rule out the possibility. But like I said, those first four that I showed, I think, in my opinion, are the most likely to get easy A's, because they're the oldest units and they definitely need it the most, especially those first two, because they just got left out from the easy A's from that story event. So I think that those are all definitely possible. But these last four, mostly just the Tech Vegito Blue and this AGL Gogeta Blue, they would be broken. It would be fun, but they would be ridiculous if they got EZA. So anyways, though, let's move into the next section of this video, which is the Part 2 LR. Now, I did only put Part 2 LR, but there's actually two LRs for this celebration. And, well, just like with the side units, I really couldn't think of any other LRs that would be for Part 2. Again, because I already talked about it earlier, but a lot of people are expecting this to be like a 7th year anniversary. So the same thing I've done for all these videos, I do put Part 2 LRs just in case they do. Like, you know, just to kind of talk about what if they did make this an anniversary, I kind of wanted to go off of that hypothetical. Because any of these celebrations I talked about, like Saiyan Saga, for example, if they don't do an anniversary, it could always be worldwide. Which, I mean, to be fair, those also do get Part 2 LRs usually. But, you know, that's the main reason, because anniversary and worldwide get Part 2 LRs. But they could drop any of these units at any time, and perhaps during a celebration that doesn't get a Part 2 LR. So that's why I just have this, you know, I have the Part 2 LR section on here just in case. So, so this is going to be kind of funny. So you remember the side units? So the first LR is a full power Super Saiyan Broly. Again, listen, I literally couldn't think of who else would be on like an LR banner like this. I mean, I know a lot of people want the Broly to be a Dokkan Fest, and I do agree. But again, my problem is I couldn't think of who else would be a Part 2 LR. Like, you know, part, like, because the 5th year anniversary, we already got like the LR Broly Chilai Lemo and then the LR Rose. So it's like, what would they do now? You know, or I guess they could do like what, LR Frieza from the Broly movie, and then like, I don't know, LR Zamasu by himself. Like, I don't know. They could, I guess. But I think that having a Broly, and obviously the second one, which I'll show right now. First, let's talk about these arts real quick, though. Is just, you know, these are all really cool shots. Especially that top left one is actually what they use for LF Broly in Legends. And, well, LF Gogeta Blue also has the same art as LR Gogeta Blue in Dokkan. So I think that that's just an iconic shot that they could use. And then, like, you know, I think all of these would be good LR arts. But yeah, so the second LR is a Fuse Zamasu. Now, I call him Merge Zamasu. That's what I personally call him. But I know Dokkan calls him Fusion Zamasu. And I also, if you notice the arts here, I kind of did match them again. So, like, the top left one has Broly and Zamasu screaming. Then the second one is more of, like, a zoom in on their face. And then the third one, they have their arm out. So, like, I kind of match them again. But it's also with Zamasu. I just think those are all really cool shots. So, yeah, and I think the Zamasu would be like the purple arm Zamasu specifically. So for the top left, they could just change one of his arms. Dokkan is known for doing that. They'll take like scenes, they'll base it off of something, but they will change it up a little bit. just to make it more like original, you know, and just to fit what they want. So yeah, like I said though, I couldn't think of any other part 2 LRs, so this is what we got going here. But I know a lot of people want these to be like Dokkan Fest instead of legendary summon banners, which I understand. But yeah, so let's go ahead and jump to the super attack. So for Broly, so I think that his 12 key super attack should be this giant like green energy ball he uses, because again, that hasn't been used in Dokkan, or even I think Legends does use this actually, yeah, but this hasn't been used at all in Dokkan. So it's like, you know, it's such a big energy like ball blast thing, so I think using it for a full power Broly is very fitting. And I think this little end scene right here with the lava is really sick, so yeah, I think that could be really cool. But yeah, so they just haven't used this at all in Dokkan, and I think it's just a really cool moment in the movie that they could use. And then for his 18 key, so just like the Gogeta Blue LR for his 12 key, there's stuff they could pull from Broly from the CGI scenes again, because they haven't used all of the CGI scenes, which actually I think this part, the 12 key, was also CGI, but this is like that specific CGI scene, you know. There's stuff that they could definitely pull from this. So you know, I'll play it again here, but basically it starts off with Broly like powering up, just because that'd be kind of cool. And then he punches Gogeta, kicks the enemy into a wall, and then he charges at them, then he punches them again, and then he starts doing all these mouth blasts that he does in the movie. I think that alone is a pretty cool 18 key super attack. They could also just switch these, because some people might argue that this big energy ball would be cooler for an 18 key. The only reason I have it as a 12 key though is because this is actually not legendary Broly doing this. So I think that would be, it'd make more sense because it's a lower form of Broly, so it being the lower super attack makes sense. This one's actually a legendary Super Saiyan Broly super attack, so that's why I have that. But yeah, I just think that these would be, again, like I said, they still have plenty of animations they could use. But now let's move into Merge Zamasu super attack. So his 12 key, what I think they could do for that is this really sick scene when he does the Blades of Judgment, specifically like this right here. They've never animated this in Dokkan. There is a Blades of Judgment in Dokkan. I don't think it's actually called Blades of Judgment though for the super attack, but they do have Zamasus that use this. But I think that doing like a fully animated one just like the anime would be cool. And it also links up with that Gallic Kamehameha scene that I had for the LR Goku and Vegeta, the Vegito one. So I think they could just use like, you know, that Blades of Judgment scene in it, because it looks really cool in my opinion. So, and then for the 18 key, basically the way I did this, so it starts off with, you know, Zamasu just punching the enemy in the gut, and then he pulls out, like, first he drops his arm, you know, and then he pulls out his energy blade, because in the anime he actually never stabbed Vegito here with it, because Vegito stabs him first. But we do actually have the STR LR Vegito Blue that uses this, so I think they could do something like original where Zamasu actually gets the stab off. Just because, you know, having merged Zamasu with the key, like the key sword on his hand, is pretty cool. So I think that would be, you know, a nice looking super attack. So yeah. Now, one thing before I get into the next section of this is, one thing they could do that I didn't mention here is similar to my, if you saw my, the second video I made about the Saiyan Saga, they could do these two, the Broly and Zamasu, as like rage mechanic units. So it would be a Super Saiyan Broly as the LR, and then he has a rage mechanic into full power, and then the Zamasu could be like a normal merge Zamasu, and then he rage mechanics into the buff one. But I honestly think it'd be more hype if these were standalone, just full power Brolys, and then merge Zamasu. You know, I think that would be a lot more hype of an LR than a rage mechanic, because rage mechanics are like temporary, and you wouldn't get to use like full power Broly and Zamasu much. So I think those would be more fitting for, you know, these LRs. So the next section though is these units actually have active skills. Now these wouldn't be like, again, like transformations or rage mechanics. I think these would just be cool, like, again, another way for them to throw in more scenes from the movie, and it would just be like a power up kind of thing. So this, so like, let's look at Broly's here. It's this scene when he starts, you know, he's like powering up, and then he does the scream with the iconic pose right here. So this would just be like a, like, maybe it gives him like key plus, like, you know, maybe it gives him full key, and then so he gets a guaranteed like 18 key super attack, and then he also gets like an attack buff. So basically the active skills here are just serving as buffs. So it's just kind of, they have a lot of units that do that. I can't think of one off the top of my head, but they have units that when you use their active skill, The physical Blue Goku and Vegeta. So they have an active skill where they go like Kaioken and evolution, but it's not actually a transformation. It's just a power up scene, and you get like an attack boost. You get your key maxed out. It does drop your defense a little, but it serves as a buff, not an actual transformation or anything. So I think that would be fitting, especially for the Broly here. So since Broly had one, I had to give one to Zamasu as well. But they actually do have a scene they could use when he, like, you know, has this lightning come out and then he starts growing. So, like, you know, his arm gets bigger and then he grows. And then so do his legs. Just, you know, the scene where he gets, like, super huge and then his eyes flash here. And that's actually where that shot from the art that I used came from. So, like, this shot right here from the art, that's where this comes from. So I just think that this would be a really cool scene to use as, again, just a buff active skill. Like, it just powers him up. And it's, again, it's a nice way to match the Broly. So if you couldn't tell, I like matching a lot of the units together because I think it's just cool. So then now the very last section of this is the honorable mention section. So there's been a lot talked about, and this video is getting kind of long, so we're just going to talk about this quick. But if you've noticed, I've been trying to hit everything for both the Goku Black arc and the Broly movie arc. Obviously the Goku Black arc still has a lot they could use, like another Sword of Hope Trunks LR or something like that. But for like the Vegito and Zamasu, at least I'm trying to get everything. But anyway, so the honorable mentions here. So the first two are this base Goku and Vegeta. These two could be potentially free to play units as well. So you're probably wondering like where this art comes from. These are actually in-game arts, but these units are only boss units. So they're only units that during the DBS Broly like story event, you only fight them. You can't actually collect them as units right now. But I think a free-to-play just base Goku and base Vegeta, like just from the Broly movie, just base form straight up, would be cool. And it's definitely a possibility because they do have, you know, the arts in the game. And I think these two do have super attacks. I haven't seen them before, I don't think, because, you know, I don't think I've ever gotten supered in the story event. But, you know, I usually just like one-shot them. So, but yeah, they could definitely make these into free-to-play units because, and again, it's just iconic from the Broly movie. And they have what they could do for super attacks. I didn't put it on here in this PowerPoint, but I think what they could do is just the very beginning when Goku and Vegeta are fighting each other. They could use that for the base form super attacks, or even just like when they're fighting Broly in base or something. I don't know. But then the very next slide is, again, from the Broly movie. They have this Raditz and then this, I think it's called a Tick, Giant Tick. Yeah. So again, these two are boss enemies that you can't actually fight or that you can't actually use. Like, these aren't free to play cards that you can collect, so I think these being free to play would also be cool. Raditz, I feel like I wasn't gonna include Raditz on this at first because the AGL Kid Vegeta is a Vegeta and Raditz card, but then people pointed out that, and I have to go back and look at it, but this Raditz apparently does have his own special super attack. So that was the reason I say he could be a free-to-play card. But at the same time, I'm a little iffy on it just because the Vegeta and Raditz is already a thing. So they kind of already represented Raditz in that card. So I don't know if they would do that. And then the Tick, I think it would just be a funny little enemy. They could just do it like the robots from the Cooler movie, where it's just like an army of them, you know? They could do something like that for the giant Ticks. And that's it for the celebration. So yeah, that's everything I got for this celebration, though. So, like I said earlier in the video, though, go check out the links below for the Gogeta and Vegito concepts that people have made that I think are pretty cool and could definitely be used. Go check those out down below. And yeah, so I mentioned this in every other video, but we're going to talk about it here too. I am, if I can figure it out, going to put these PowerPoints that I made into a Google Drive. And I'm going to let you guys save like your own copies of the Google Drive, not let you edit the original one, but let you save your own copies. So that way you can create your own concepts if you want, and you can just base it off of mine. So if you don't want to, if you don't feel like going through a whole, like starting from scratch, you can just base it off of mine and then add or remove stuff or even move stuff around, change stuff. Like for example, the last four Easy A's, I was actually going to put down in honorable mentions, but I decided to just have them all be under the Easy A section just because it flowed better that way. But yeah, so you can move stuff around. You can add stuff, remove stuff. You can even change up the super attacks, like whatever you want to do. I'll let you base it off of this, though, if you want. And if you do make a concept, then, you know, tag me on Twitter. Like, show, if you make a video on it, maybe show me it on Twitter. Or you can even send me your own Google Drive link and tag me on Twitter. My Twitter link is in the bio. So, you know, go follow me and then tag me whenever you do make your own concepts. Or if you don't feel like doing the whole Google Drive PowerPoint thing, you can even just leave a comment of what your concept would be for this celebration, or like, you know, maybe just something like, if you don't want to do a whole concept in a comment, you could just like, oh, I would have put this instead for your Gogeta, for example. Like, just take what I did and change stuff around in the comment. Or you could even tag me on Twitter doing the same thing. It doesn't have to be a comment. You can make a Twitter post talking about your concept for anything I talked about in this video or any of the videos I made so far. But if you're going to leave a comment, then, you know, kind of leave it specifically to this video. If you have like a comment about the Saiyan Saga one, it'd be best to go comment on that video, just because it makes it more organized and I can see everything better that way. But yeah, so that's basically it for these three celebrations that I've been talking about so far, which is Resurrection F, Saiyan Saga, and then Blue Fusions. So again, like I said at the very beginning, if you want, I do have two more ideas that I could do, but I'm going to wait and for you guys to decide, you know, by liking and commenting and all that, and then I'll do those if you want to see them. If not, then I won't do them. I might make like a Twitter post about it or something, but I'm not gonna make a whole like PowerPoint. These things take a while to make, let me tell you. These things do take a long time, especially when your computer won't cooperate. It's a mess. But yeah, that's basically it from me though. That was my concept. Like I said, drop comments or, you know, check the Google Drive link if I figured out how to do it. And yeah, let me know what your concept would be. And if you do make one, tag me on Twitter. If you do make like a whole PowerPoint, you can either make a video on it and show me that way, or just send me the Google Drive link on Twitter and I'll take a look at it, because you guys might have some great ideas that I didn't think about. So I'm sure you will. But yeah, that's it for me though. So until next time, I'll see you all later, and peace. Have a good day or night, y'all.